Dear students, Taro's Reward is a popular fairy tale in Japan. The story of a son Taro who wanted to fulfill the wishes of his father. So let's start our today's lesson. But before that, I want to take you all to the tour of Japan. So hold your seats. We are going to see Japan live on your screen. Japan is an island country of East Asia in Northwest Pacific Ocean. It is one of my favorite country because of many reasons. The first is, it is world's third powerful economy. The in ancient time in 1860, the federal lords were ruling there in a several different areas of Japan. And what I like personally about Japan is their moral education. The way they teach to their children is totally a different approach. Moral character and integrity is the best knowledge that you will get in every school of Japan. So let's discuss a bit more about Japan. So Japan had no natural resources, and with high colonial ambition, what they did, they fought with Russia, Korea, China, Thailand in World War I. And in 1905, even they defeated the powerful country Russia. In World War II, Japan attacked on Pearl Harbor, America on 7 December 1941. That was the biggest trigger. Because in 1945, in return, America, what did to Japan, that we all know, the Hiroshima and Nagasaki, was largely destroyed by an atomic bomb during World War II. Japanese are risk averse person. Tsunamis and earthquakes are common in Japan. So from 1947 to 1991, it was a very tough time for Japan. In year 2011, the biggest crisis for Japan was the 2011 tsunami. But they have taught to the whole world that they are the best out of the best. They shows the best discipline in during the crisis. There were zero crime rate in the period of 2011. They were following all the rules in the crisis also. What I like about that, during that time, everyone was, even for food, they were always being a line waiting for their turn. They shows the best discipline in that particular period. Few more achievements and fact and figure about Japan is, they have built their first bullet train in 1964 before Tokyo Olympic Games. The Japanese people are obsessed with punctuality, and an average one train in Japan can only 6.5 second delay in 1 year. If any train be late, then they will issue you train delay certificate, which you can show to your job or their work where you are working. The best thing I like about them is punctuality. They are very punctual person. Second, morally, the social responsible. From the school life only, they are teaching to their kids that what are the social responsibility that you have to take. Kids, I want to share one famous incident. Once in a Japan, one Indian and one Japanese were driving a car, and midnight 3 o'clock, when Japanese person saw red light and he stopped the car in mid of the way, then Indian guy told to him that, why you stop, no one is here, we can jump the red light. Then he told to the Indian person that if in far away any building balcony, a child might watch and learn that jumping red light is legal. Why should I set a wrong example for him? That shows the best discipline and their moral quality. And one more best example of their commitment and their service is Toyota cars. Taro's Reward. A young woodcutter named Taro lived with his mother and father on a lonely hillside. All day long he chopped wood in the forest. Though he worked very hard, he earned very little money. This made him sad, for he was a thoughtful son and wanted to give his old parents everything they needed. One evening, when Taro and his parents were sitting in a corner of their hut, a strong wind began to blow. It whistled through the cracks of a hut and everyone felt very cold. Suddenly, Taro's father said, "I wish I had a cup of shake. It would warm me and do my old hurt good." This made Taro sadder than ever, for the heartwarming drink called shake was very expensive. How do I earn more money? He asked himself. How do I get little shake for my poor old father? He decided to work harder than before. Next morning, Taro jumped out of bed earlier than usual and made his way to the forest. He chopped and cut as the sun climbed, and soon he was so warm that he had to take off his jacket. His mouth was dry and his face was wet with sweat. My poor old father, he thought, if only he was as warm as I. And with that, he began to chop even faster, thinking of the extra money he must earn to buy the shake to warm the old man's bone. Then suddenly, Taro stopped chopping. What was the sound he heard? Could it possibly be rushing water? Taro could not remember ever seeing or hearing a rushing stream in that part of the forest. He was thirsty. The axe dropped out of his hands and he ran in the direction of the sound. Taro saw a beautiful little waterfall hidden behind a rock, kneeling at a place where the water flowed quietly. He cupped a little in his hands and put it to his lips. Was it water or was it shake? He tasted it again and again, and always it was the delicious shake. Taro quickly filled the pitcher he had with him and hurried home. The old man was delighted with the shake. After only one swallow of the liquid, he stopped shivering and did a little dance in the middle of the floor. That afternoon, a neighbor stopped by for a visit. Taro's father politely offered her a cup of the shake. The lady drank it greedily and thanked the old man. Then Taro told her the story of the magic waterfall. Thanking them for the delicious drink, she left in a hurry. By nightfall, she had spread the story throughout the whole village. That evening, there was a long procession of visitors to the woodcutter's house, Taro. Each man heard the story of the waterfall and took a sip of shake. In less than an hour, the pitcher was empty. Next morning, Taro started for work even earlier than the morning before. He carried with him the largest pitcher he owned for the instant first of all to go to the waterfall. When he reached it, he found to his great surprise all his neighbors there. They were carrying pitchers, jars, buckets, anything they could find to hold the magic shake. Then one villager knelt and held his mouth under the waterfall to drink. He drank again and again and then shouted angrily, "Water, nothing but water." Other also tried, but there was no shake. "We have been tricked," shouted the villagers. "Where is Taro? Let us drown him in this waterfall." But Taro had been wise enough to slip behind a rock when he saw how things were going. He was nowhere to be found. Muttering their anger and disappointment, the villagers left the place one by one. Taro came out from his hiding place. Was it true? He wondered. Was the shake a dream? Once more, he caught a little liquid in his hand and put it to his lips. It was the same fine shake to the thoughtful. The story of Taro and his magic waterfall reached the emperor of Japan. He sent for the young woodcutter and rewarded him with 20 pieces of gold for having been so good and kind. Then he named the most beautiful fountain in the city after Taro. This, said the emperor, was to encourage all children to honor and obey their parents. The story is of a thoughtful and loving son who looks after his parents. His dedication and thoughtfulness is rewarded by the Almighty and later on by the king when he heard about the incident. So let's begin Taro's reward. Taro is a loving son There lived a woodcutter named Taro in a village of Japan with his family. He earned his living by woodcutting and lived on a hillside. His income was meager. He could fulfill the basic need of the family. One day, through the cracks of his hut, cold wind shivered Taro's father. At this, Taro's father wished for a cup of shake, a drink to warm his body. Taro was sad as he could not afford to get the drink. So he decided to work harder to earn more money. Next day, he got up early to cut more woods. He went to drink water from a nearby fountain as he was thirsty. He found that the taste of the water was different. Then he realized that it was shake. He filled the pitcher with it. He brought it along and gave it to his father. After taking a sip of it, the father stopped shivering and danced a little. That day, a visitor came and Taro offered the shake to her and told the whole story about shake. Next morning, all the villagers reached there before Taro. The village went to the waterfall with pitchers, etc., but they found that it was only water, so they were very angry with Taro. Taro had to save himself from the anguish of the villagers. But when he tested himself, it was again the same shake. The news reached the ear of the emperor, means the king of that particular place. Taro was rewarded by the emperor of Japan for being good and kind. So that was all about our lesson, Taro Reward.